Good morning, everyone. It's Ms. Finnegan here, and today is day 12 of our flexible learning model, Instruction from Home. And today I'm wearing my Gryffindor shirt in honor of Harry Potter. Let's take a look at a quote of the day, because that has something to do with Harry Potter, too. Our quote of the day is, "Happiness can be found, even in the darkest of times, if one remembers to turn on the light." So, I love that quote by Albus Dumbledore, who is the headmaster of Hogwarts, and that means that even in dark times, even in uncertain times, even in times where you might feel a little frightened, we can always find positivity and light if we turn on the light for ourselves. So remember, that means that you have to look for the good. And I remember us finding things to be grateful for was another one of our quotes. So Harry Potter for the win. Let's look at our agenda of the day. Okay, our agenda today. In reading, we will be having a choice activity. I'm going to head over to this slide and remind you what the choices are. You may design a new cover if you didn't already. You may write a new ending for one of your books. You may create a new title for one of your books and explain why. Or you may find 5 new vocabulary words and find synonyms and antonyms. Sorry, I actually was using Asheria's slideshow today to show my example. So thanks, Ash, for letting us see that awesome piece of yours. So, day 12, new ending is what I chose. I'm going to read mine to you. Harry and his friends were gathered at Hogwarts. They saw Bellatrix Lestrange standing out by the gates. She could not get in because the castle was enchanted with spells against evil. All of a sudden, a loud crack boomed in the sky. The ground began to shake. The kids had to run for their lives. The only place to run was out towards the gates, right to Bellatrix. She was waiting there, cackling her evil laugh. "Get your wands out," Harry shouted to Hermione and Ron. He did as he said. Harry stepped forward and led the way. He told his friends to run on the count of 3. They all ran at full speed towards Bellatrix. "Expelliarmus!" Ron shouted. Bellatrix laughed and blocked the spell. "Stupefy!" Hermione shouted. Bellatrix dodged the spell easily. Suddenly, without planning it, they all summoned the 3 Patronus charms. "Patronum!" rang through the air. Harry's stag bolted at Bellatrix. She ran, but it caught her. The 3 Patronus charmed animals fought Bellatrix at the edge of the lake. She stumbled and lost hold of her wand. In an instant, Dumbledore and Professor McGonagall were there. "Back to Azkaban she goes." So that was an ending that I wrote. I actually don't know how my book ends yet. I'm still reading Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince. But if I had to write an ending that I would like Bellatrix Lestrange, who is the evil character in the story, along with Voldemort, to be sent back to Azkaban. So that's why I wrote something about that. If you could create your own ending, what would you create? So that brings us from reading to writing. In writing today, we are going to continue working on our personal narratives, wrapping up our conclusions and rereading to revise and edit. Here, I'm actually in Akarsh's writing. Akarsh, I love reading your writing. He has done a great job in putting his paragraphs in beginning and middle and end. He's also indented. Really awesome job. I see a few red underlines, so he's going to reread for spelling. Remember, when we revise and edit, we revise to make it look better. We revise to make it sound better. So when you revise, you think of arms, adding, removing, my goodness, my brain, I think all those spells are in my mind, adding, removing, substituting, and moving. So you want to move your words around, move your thoughts around, and rearrange. When you edit, you think cuts. So capitalize, usage, punctuation, and spelling. So we want to make our writing sound the best to our reader and also look the best to our reader so the stories are clear. And remember, your reader is me and also Miss Murphy and maybe even Miss Cave. So we're on the look for great stories and we want to be entertained because we miss you. So your stories are the best things we have to talk to you besides Flipgrid. Okay, let's move on to math today. I must say, I absolutely love hearing and looking at your math on here because I can see it live. So today you're going to be doing multi-step number stories. You'll watch this quick video for fun. You'll do this slide. You'll do this slide. You'll do some fact practice. And then you've arrived at your math game slide. Remember, anytime you're struggling, you can create a comment in the slide and I will be able to go in there really quickly. Yesterday, I was able to help out Holden really quickly. I was able to help out Violetta really quickly because I could type right in the boxes and say, remember, 7 baskets with 10 in each means 7 times 10. I think that was actually about me having stickers in there, one of our word problems. Okay, so remember, if you have any questions, to ask me in the comments. Now, the last thing we're going to talk about is social studies. Social studies activity of the day is all about the book Memory Coat. So, in our social studies slide, I've replaced all the other stories with just the one of Memory Coat.
The Memory Coat, written by Elvira Woodruff.
The Memory Coat, written by Elvira Woodruff, is actually a book that I read to you right before we started our flexible learning. Now, you might not have been in school, you can listen to it there. Now, the Memory Coat is all about Grisha and her cousin traveling from Russia to America. And the Memory Coat is a coat that kept Grisha's cousin warm and safe. But there was a tragic thing that happened. He fell and hurt his eye, and then the inspectors at Ellis Island thought that he was sick. So they almost didn't let him in, and they put a big mark on his coat to say, don't allow him into America. But they turned it inside out. And there's a whole lot more detail that I want you to hear. Today, you're going to design your own memory coat. Mine is green because that's from Ireland. And you're also going to write a journal entry pretending to be a little girl or boy traveling from a country to America. So on my coat, I have an S. I wanted to pretend like maybe my grandmother or something put an S for my name. I have a 4-leaf clover. I have a patch because I'm thinking it would be an old coat from Ireland and maybe it would need to be patched up. I have a few stitches on there, thinking maybe there's a rip or something that needed to be patched up, and I have some designs all around. So here's my journal entry, talking about my memory coat, and I'm pretending to be somebody. My memory coat kept me warm as my family sailed from Ireland to America. We arrived in New York City. It was so beautiful there, but we were cramped in the boat. When we tried to get off the ramp in a line to get to Ellis Island, there were so many people. I buttoned up my coat and grabbed my sister's hand in the cool, cool breeze. I was excited, but scared for our new life in America. And that would be my fake character traveling from Ireland to America. I can't wait to see what you guys write about. All right, remember, like every day, you can ask questions, post your work, or say hello on Flipgrid. Also, a special treat today, chapters, I believe 13 and 14 is what we're up to, were read by Miss Murphy. So she added that YouTube video into your slides if you want to listen to James and the Giant Peach. Okay, everyone, talk with you soon. Great job. Bye.